Hey gardening friends, I'm out in the garden today. It's May 23rd. Thought I'd do a plant spotlight on golden alexanders. Its botanical name is Zizia aurea, Z-I-Z-I-A, A-U-R-E-A. Now this plant is native from eastern Canada down into southern U.S. and it is one of the host plants for some of our swallowtail butterflies. They can also lay their eggs on parsley, fennel, and dill. They're all in the carrot family. So we have these lovely yellow flowers that are attractive to a number of pollinators. When I first came out, there were some flower flies, there was a bee, and there were some small insects. And I'll see if I can find the flower fly for you. And here's another little insect. So this is great to add to your native plant collection. They do start blooming in early May, and they've been blooming for a couple weeks now. They prefer full sun to part shade. Where I have them in my garden, they get morning sun, and then they are spared hot afternoon sun. They do like a more moist soil, so I know that my garden dries out, so I have them where they're gonna get morning sun and not as stressed from later in the afternoon, too much heat. So they really can tolerate a number of soil conditions, but they do want more moisture in the spring when they're growing and blooming. And these will bloom into June. You can see we still have some buds coming on. And I'd say my plants are about 2 feet tall, maybe a little bit taller than that. I know they can get 1 to 3 feet tall depending on what kind of moisture they have. They would be a great plant for rain gardens or to mass naturalize in a meadow or in a pollinator bed. I did read that they're a short-lived perennial, but they will self-sow if they're happy. So then that way it keeps the stand going. And mine are growing underneath black walnuts, and they've been here a couple years, so they seem okay with that. They're also deer resistant, and I have rabbits in the garden and they have not bothered the golden alexanders. So good plant if you're having problems with deer. As I said before, they're a good pollinator plant and they're hardy in zones 3 through 8. They can also make good cut flowers for spring bouquets. And what else about them? Oh, if you have heavy clay soils, they will also adapt to that. And they can adapt to some drier conditions. So great plant to add to your pollinator bed or just your more native naturalized areas. And I just wanted to introduce you to golden alexanders. All right. Have a great day.